And tell your neighbor, God is Trinity.
God is Trinity.
So say the triune God, that means that the God who is free but one. And we are tripartite, that means that we are three but at the same time one. Now watch this. All these three parts of ours and the three parts of God have their various functions. Jesus has what he does. The Holy Spirit has what he does. And God the Father has what he does. And it's the same thing that applies to us. The body has what he does. The soul has what he does. And the spirit also has what he does. Are you hearing me, somebody? When you are asleep and you are dreaming, it is not your body you see. Sometimes you sleep and you see yourself in a very big mansion. You are like a king. And whilst you are walking, people are just around you, so many servants and maids around you, and you are so happy, riding in big cars and all that. You wake up and you find yourself on your tiny bed in that kiosk. Have you had such a dream before? You see, you have some dream that makes you so happy and you wish you will never wake up. And in the dream you think is real, but you wake up and you see yourself on your tiny bed. Tell your neighbor, go back to your tiny bed. Oh God. Hallelujah to Jesus. So the soul has its function, the spirit has its function, and the body has its function. And I said that whenever the enemy enters into one's life, the first thing the enemy targets in your life is your soul, not your body, not your spirit. Why? Because your spirit is not you, your body is not you, but your soul is you. Tap your neighbor and say, your soul is you. Tell your neighbor, overfill your soul. And I said that when anyone dies, whether the person is a believer or an unbeliever, the person's spirit goes to God, because the spirit is of the Lord. The Bible says that, and when God formed man from the dust of the soil, God breathed into man, and the Bible says that a man became a living soul. So the breath of God that entered man was the spirit of God. So when one dies, the spirit goes back to the maker, because the spirit is of the maker. The body goes back to the soil, because the body is of the soil. And now the soul goes to heaven or hell. Tell you about heaven or hell. And I said that the soul goes to heaven when the soul accepted Jesus Christ whilst on earth, and the soul goes to hell if the soul did not accept Jesus as Lord and Savior. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one goes unto the Father except through me. That means that until you accept Jesus as Lord and Savior, forget heaven. Amen. And I said that since the enemy is longing and he is after our souls, that we should be very careful whatsoever thing we are doing with the soul. And I said that the soul is invincible. We don't see it with our naked eyes. And so therefore, everything the body does is that which affects the soul. If the body is moving in the will of God and working according to the precepts of Christ, it happens that in the realms of the spirit, the soul is in accordance to God's will. And it's the same thing that happens when the soul is not working by the will of God and living by the will of God, and the body is living anyhow. The moment the body is living anyhow, in the realms of the spirit, that which the body is doing, which is negative, is affecting the soul negatively. And by reason of that, the soul is connected to the kingdom of the devil and not the kingdom of God. Tell your neighbor, be connected to God. Tap your neighbor and say, be connected to God. Tap your neighbor and say, be connected to God. Now ask your neighbor, who are you connected to? Yesterday, the Lord brought us to another dimension, and we're talking about what soul tie is. Soul tie is when two souls have been joined together to be made one. The Bible says that, and the two shall be one. And I made it clear yesterday, when the Bible says the two shall be one, when the couple comes before the altar and they are prayed for and blessed in the realms of the spirit, God has joined them to be one. But as a matter of fact, it's the marriage bed that makes the two to be one. Because that is when the man enters the woman and the woman enters the man. That is when the man has access into the woman and the woman has access into the man. So therefore, if I am not married and I am just sleeping around, or I am just doing anything with my body, in the realms of the spirit, I am contaminating my soul. So as a child of God, you have to be very careful the kind of person you are with and the kind of person you are doing that with. Now I tell you this. The person you went to bed with, what kind of spirit did the person carry? Ask your neighbor, what kind of spirit? Ask your neighbor, what kind of spirit? Ask your neighbor, what kind of spirit? Tell your neighbor, the way you are looking at me, I'm suspecting you. So now, if you are a young man or a young woman and you want to maybe rub shoulders with friends and you want to also you want your friends to also see you are also there, say they come, so you also want to rub shoulders and therefore you go to any extent of doing anything just to get money in order to feel you are there. You are not destroying anybody, you are destroying your own self. At the end of the day, nature watches. Aside the judgment of God, nature has a way of dealing with man. Nature has a way of disciplining us. Nature has a way of judging us. I would say that whatsoever thing a man sows, he shall reap. You are following someone's husband, be ready. When you get married, even if that one will come, I don't know. If that one should come, if it happens, get ready that someone also follow your husband. Tell your neighbor, get ready. Or tell your neighbor about fear. Now, everything we are doing in this life, we are not deceiving anybody, we are deceiving our own selves. How can you ever say you are deceiving your own self? We come to church and we polish ourselves, and you see the women with all the makeups, very nice and very beautiful, but their spirits are contaminated, their souls are contaminated. And most often, you open the bag of a woman, you see everything in the bag, eye stick, nose stick, lipstick, and pen stick, and all the sticks, but you will not see a Bible stick. Tonight I came to command that after tonight may you carry a Bible stick in your purse and in your bag. May you carry God around wherever you are. Jesus said, seek ye first the kingdom and all other things shall be added unto you. I pray for you in the name of Jesus that may you love and love to carry Jesus around wherever you find yourself. The whole of last week I was in Kumasi, this week I'm here, next week I'll be in ICGC Kumasi, the following week another ICGC, the fourth week another ICGC, then the fifth week Assemblies of God, North Kalish, my spiritual fellowship, then the sixth week another week, so my voice have to be intact. Tap your neighbor and say, Umafi. So now, therefore, as we long to listen, I'm not saying dressing is bad, I'm not saying keeping yourself is bad, I'm not saying painting your face is wrong, that is what I'm saying. But let everything you are doing, do not gear it towards getting a man or enticing a particular rich man. Watch this. Do it to the glory of the Lord. For your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. If my body is the temple of the Holy Spirit, then I must glory God in my body. Are you hearing me, somebody? I must glorify God in my body. Everything I do must be to God's own glory and not to man's glory. Tap your neighbor and say, please God, and not man. Tap your neighbor and say, please God, and not man. Tap your neighbor and say, please God. I will not love that woman. If no one is watching, don't forget, there is a man up there who always watches over everything we do. Are you hearing me, somebody? Top your neighbor and tell your neighbor, God is watching. Top your neighbor and say, God is watching. Top your neighbor and say, God is watching. Let me tell you this secret. Women have lots of problems. Coach me everywhere and call me anywhere, I'll defend myself. Why am I saying that? The things we use on ourselves in the realms of the spirit destroy us. Most of the things. Men, we don't paint any eye stick and nose stick and lipstick. But women do the painting. And most of these things that you paint on your body are things that are not connected to God. I'm not saying don't paint yourself. That is what I'm saying. Now watch this. Sometimes the cutest you buy to paint your nails and the lipstick you use on your lips, wash it. Sometimes just what underneath, beneath it, you realize a cobra has been drawn on it. Mama, you've seen it before. Excellent. You have a witness. You have another person who has seen it before. You have also seen it, my sister. Excellent. Cobra. Why not any other animal but cobra? Watch this. In the garden. is the devil turned into what? Into what? Yeah. Wow, believers here who read your Bibles. What did the devil turn into? Yeah. I said, so when you have a dream and you are seeing snakes in your dreams, in the realms of the spirit, it's a satanic attack because snakes are connected to Satan. So why didn't any animal, why wasn't any animal drawn on the lipstick or the eye stick or the painting stick or whatever? How you call it? Hello? But why was a snake drawn on it? Now, just that symbol should show you where the thing is coming from. So most of us, we were okay until we began to paint. Most of us were okay until we wore a particular dress. Some of us were okay until we started showing some parts of our body. And they say, Charlie, and then you're not hot, we might feel hot. Ask your neighbor, do you want to make it to heaven or do you want to be hot? Tap your neighbor and say, do you want to make it to heaven or do you want to be hot? Shake somebody and say, heaven or hot? Yeah, that's right. As a woman, you should not dress and show some vital parts of your body. 95% of women in this world are having spiritual marriage. 95%. By God's grace, we see a little in the spirit. So some of these things we understand and we know. Now watch this. There was one sister I was praying for some years back. A very fine looking, beautiful sister. She's very beautiful. As a fact of the matter, I didn't get that one. I fear. Some are fearfully made and some are wonderfully made. This one is a wonderful one. Are you hearing me, somebody? Now, the sister was 28 years by then. We were praying for her. At that time, she was dating one man. The man was so rich. The man wasn't a married man. The man was so rich. The man wanted to marry this lady. But whenever the man takes the step of going to perform the marriage rite, something will happen. So therefore, by God's grace, we came in contact with them and we decided to pray with them. I invited this sister one day to our all night. And whilst I was praying for her, the Lord showed me a revelation. When she was 7 years, in those times, the father and the mother were not rich. And at that time, you see what I got, they go out in a mountain with Gary Badam. So while she was laughing, not knowing there was a spirit that was passing, the spirit was just what? Passing. The spirit saw the body, and all of a sudden the spirit loved the body and entered the body. And from that day, the lady was married to that spirit unknowingly. When spirits are getting married to you, they don't tell you, they don't announce you, they don't perform any marriage rites, they just love you and enter. When you are married spiritually, everything you try to do on the physical concerning getting married will never hold. Every man that will come into your life, you may be very beautiful on the outside, but every man that will come into your life will leave you disappointed. Why? Because you are already married. Tap the neighbor and say, it's serious. I am so beautiful, so by all means a man will come and who like you. Sometimes look at the people who are married, excuse me to say, Obafe and Nimsha, Obafe Sebe, Obafe, but they are married. You see, so when it comes to marriage, it's not about beauty, it's about favor. Shout favor. Are you telling me that when King Ahasuerus chose Esther over the rest of the women, it meant Esther was more beautiful? No, Esther carried favor. There were other women who were more beautiful because no matter how much you feel you are beautiful, someone looks more nicer than you. Are you hearing me, somebody? There was someone who was more beautiful than Esther, but Esther carried something that others didn't carry, and that is what I call favor. Tonight I ask, may every woman and every man in this house receive divine favor. Your amen is too weak. Your amen is too weak. Shout your loudest amen. So stop shaking yourself and stop painting yourself and making yourself like a masquerade. I know after tonight the women will not love me again. Can I stand here and preach to only the men? Joy never as a child of God. You have to look very good. Tell me about it glorifies God. But Paul talks about modesty. Doing it in modesty. Moderate. It should be moderate and not overboard. And dear, we are serving bare money in the middle of one and the son and you know, son of home rules you want a young one. That is what you saw in this way. As a woman, you should not dress and allow anybody to see. You see, your knee. Oh, sir, we need to go to be a children. Your friend and nine cockles around. On nine outside. There is something there. And when a man sees the nine cockle, they now face some form of attraction. And therefore, if nothing can attract a man, it can attract a spirit. This one is serious. I'm not joking, I'm very serious. Hello? There is no way you should dress for a man to see your tie. Talk to me and say your tie. Tell you about the tie is for the bedroom. And it's for your husband. Tell you about it's not for the public. Am I preaching to somebody? Yeah. When you say, But I have to preach what God is telling me to preach. Are you hearing me? I have to preach what He wants me to preach. And I have to do what He wants me to do. Things are said, what's all about things you see me do is what I have seen the Father do. I pray for you that may you do the will of God. I said, may you do the will of God. May you live in accordance with God's will. And not in accordance to the dictates of this world. In the name of Jesus, may you not conform yourself to the things of this world, but may you be conformed to the image of Christ. In the name of the Lord Jesus, may holiness be seen with your life, and may righteousness be seen with your life. If you believe the word of God, shout amen.
I know some people will be seeing you.
Now watch. Another part you should not expose as a woman is this part of your body. Tell me about this part of your body. Why? Because there are some things that God has deposited in that region of your body. And those things, when men see on the physical, it attracts them. And so therefore, when spirits also see it, it will attract them. That line between this region should not be seen by anybody on the place. But now they showcase it. This is like when you come to our churches. We want to look too good to the extent that we want to show our feet. They will put the cross of Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Some women will go to the market, buy a ring, and put it on their finger. And they will not put it on any finger, the finger that is used to for marriage. That is what they will put the finger in. Or Toma Karanua Montano, or their son and son, you know, or now we'll see your quality. Now, come on, if I'm free, now the real talk, I wouldn't know yet, come on. The real free as a little war. Now, one of you see that toy here. There's a dark yet of one toy. Now, one toy, I've been to the 157 here. I hung out. I have been praying. I have prayed for so many young ladies who were not getting married because they had a ring they bought by themselves and they put on this finger. Some of these things you ought to know and understand. Tell the neighbor, know and understand it. Paul said the other day, we are not ignorant of the devices of the enemy. You should not be ignorant about some of these things. Because these things that we just see them and this one is nothing. They are the same thing that are destroying us. I pray that may the Lord open your eyes. I said, I pray that Jehovah open your eyes. I said, may Jehovah open your eyes. In the name of the Lord Jesus. You are beautiful. And then we'll be the other one. And then you'll be the other one. rise to three people, so everybody by me, say, can't say, without fear, without fear. And then you are without fear, go up on you. The devil has stolen so many marriages without your notice, without your knowledge. The devil has destroyed so many destinies because of your negligence and your ignorance. Do not live this life anyhow. You know the kind of friends you have. They are friends who will tell you, let's go to the nightclub. Let's go to the party. Let's go to the... They are always taking you to there. Friends who will not see reason with your dreams and aspirations. Friends who will not encourage you, let's go to the house of the Lord. The reason I was glad when they said, let us go into the house of the Lord. Let us go. That means that someone was calling him to come with you. Where do people call you to? Most of the things we use on ourselves are the same things destroying our lives. As a child of God, everything you buy, whatsoever gift that people give to you, you should not rush in taking them in or putting them on. But first of all, you should be ready to pray over them, sanctifying it with the blood of the Lamb. Do not just use the lipstick, sanctify. Do not just use the nose stick, sanctify. Do not just use the eye stick, sanctify. Do not just put on that dress, that gift you are giving, sanctify. There are some things you buy for me and for 1 year I've not put them on. I don't feel like putting them on. Until I feel in my spirit it is right to put it on, I will never put it on. That is my life. Because some of these things are dangerous. Apparel or top of one top, Master Master Tarin, another one. If anything on your body, you won't play on one question. Catalan, you will feel only a jet fire to your home. Now, on some of the room, Bible says, break the head and the serpent will bite. We have broken the hedges around us, we have broken the protections around our lives, and the enemy has entered to destroy. But tonight I pray that every entry, every chance, every opening in your life that the enemy has had access to, may the Lord shut it and command that spirit out of your body. Command that spirit out of your life. Command that spirit out of your heart. In the name of Jesus, may every evil spirit that has encapsulated your life leave you tonight in the name of the Lord. May every power of the enemy your body, that has entered your marriage, that has entered your finances, break loose right now. May the Lord redeem your soul. May the Lord redeem your soul. May the Lord redeem your soul. And I'm preaching to believers or unbelievers. I said, may the Lord bring deliverance. May the Lord change your life. May the Lord deliver you from any form of spirit. In the name of Jesus, may the Lord free your life. May the Lord bring sanity. In the name of Jesus Christ, shout deliverance. Shout deliverance. Shout deliverance.
One mistake that Christians are doing to me, they think they can just go for the Bible. They can just go and see the prophet. And after oil is poured on them and prayed for them, they will be delivered. It's a lie from the pit of hell. It doesn't happen that way. Do not deceive yourself. Bible says that God cannot be mocked. Whatsoever thing a man sows, so shall he reap. Be very careful the things you are sowing now, because tomorrow you may regret.
I know you will not cry. Don't worry. A young girl, thank God you are young, and allow the Holy Spirit to use you for the purpose of God, so that tomorrow by this time you can stand and tell a testimony. Are you hearing me, somebody? Do not waste your years. Do not waste your days, because time spent cannot be regained. When you waste the time, it is the end of you. What are you doing with your life now? Make hay while the sun is shining. Are you hearing me, somebody? I pray that after this week, you will live a purpose-driven life. Be serious with those who are serious, and ignore those who are not serious. There are some friends in your life that are wasting your life. They are not helping you. You know it yourself. After today, sit down, take inventory of your life. Begin to list your friends and commot some people, as they will say in the broken English. Commot some people from your life. Are you hearing me, somebody? Commot some people from your friendship list. Some people are not qualified enough to be your friends, because the kind of destiny you carry, they don't understand. The kind of hope you have, they don't get it. What you want to do in this life, they don't understand. And that is why the devil has brought them into your life, to pull your life back, to disturb you, and to distort your path. I pray for you, in the name of Jesus, that may the Lord help you to dissociate yourself from the things of this world. The Bible says that friendship to this world is enmity with God, and enmity with this world is friendship with God. Of God or the friendship of this world. I pray for you in the name of Jesus. May you desire the friendship of God in the name of Jesus. Most of the people say, I desire the friendship of God. But when you look at the kind of life they are living, you realize that no, they are far. What they said, it was just by mouth. Father, I love you. It was just by mouth. Jesus said, if you love me, you will obey my commandment. Say, Jesus.
Jesus.
Touch my life.
Touch my life.
You are a young man in the building. You think you are so handsome. Then all the women are following you. And because they are crossing you, you are also crossing them. Don't worry. One day you will be crossing yourself. Are you hearing me, somebody? I command you to repent in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Because whatsoever thing you are doing now, tomorrow, have you heard this old song? My yes, I will be. You are a good you are fucking free. My yes, I will be. We are just dancing with it. They don't take any lesson from a song. They don't learn anything from a song. They just dance it and sing it without meditating on the words. This is the moment. Tell the neighbor you cannot waste today. Tell the neighbor you cannot waste this moment. Tell the neighbor you cannot waste this time. Tell the neighbor you cannot waste it away. Do not waste your life. Sabe na wa yesa wobe ware no. Tina no. Omo bi o, oni bi o. Sa wo hwa wo ni suade ehun ko aye den. Tina no. And then when I show me in car, I say, or tell one into you. Now it's not to us. Are you hearing me, somebody?
Yes.
Do something for your life and make sure you are realizing something at the end of the day. Most women, they say, the criteria, no? Say, bad man, listen. All right, okay, well. Cars don't get men. It is men who get cars. So today, if I don't have a car, tomorrow I can get a car. I have to marry the vision I carry and not the money I possess. Are you hearing me, somebody? Not the money I possess, but the vision I carry. Amen. Oh, you know what? I'm not gold. I know you also. That's what I say, Matthew. Anything about every known and unknown sin. Which one are you talking about? Tell God what you have done. Tell God. One person could not share with you. Any of you want to watch for a second? As a son of a man, because most of the time, confession is not ever on the function now.
I'm evil.
to you. I'm not going back anymore. Make me anew. Wash me. Cleanse me. Purify me. Write my name in the book of life. In the name of Jesus. Come into my life. Lord Jesus. By your spirit. And let it be. You will enable me to walk by your will. In Jesus' name. Amen. Let me pray for you. Father, we thank you for these ones who have recommitted themselves unto you. Accept us. Take us as we are. Wash us. Purify us. Cleanse us. Forgive our sins. Have mercy over our lives. From today, cause our lives to make a new turn. Write our names in the book of life. Protect us from evil. Prevent us from evil. Let not the enemy have chance in our lives. In Jesus' name, amen. Give the Lord a hand. Give the people that.
Lord, have your way. Lord, I'll give you. Lord.
Come, my darling. Give me that time.
Amen. Hallelujah.
age 4, age 5. And I saw at that test, that age, I see in the spirit that you were battling with some sicknesses and some things in your system. And I see in the spirit that those things are about to surface. And I heard in the spirit, let us make I don't want to mention it.
Never fail me yet. Never fail me yet.
And it shall not take effect in your life.
You are God alone from before time began.
I guess so. I saw in the spirit that someone was holding a flag. The flag was very white, but they had painted the flag. It was like the flag had been used in a mud. And I saw in the flag, Eva, E-F-A-H. And I saw in the script that that person was being trampled upon. Thank you, Holy Ghost. But the Lord said, he, God, is bringing deliverance. Because I saw in the spirit that all of a sudden, the flag was lifted up again. And I saw that the Lord had made it as white as snow. And the Lord said, your joy and your glory has been lifted once again. Lift your hand. Touch your God. Every cloth that has been vetted about your life, any personality that has been vetted about your life, in the name of Jesus, the Lord has delivered you. I see the Lord wiping the tears of your eyes. And the Lord said, weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. In the morning. In the morning. Stretch your hand and say, Jesus, as we clap and pray, help your daughter now. Clap your hands and pray.
Lift your voice and praise.
I come to you, I was close to come to you. Thank you. There is glory on your head. I don't know, but I see it in the spirit. You are meeting someone called Destiny Helper. And God is causing you to shine his light. Take the power.
And I saw in the spirit
They were asked to do something which is very expensive. I saw them going with a cow. Money worth a cow. Taking it to that place to sacrifice in order to spread the child in the womb. So I saw in the spirit, your wife is going to have a series of complications in this pregnancy. And I saw that on the day of delivery, the doctors will say that when things are going, cesarean needs to be performed on her. And I saw in the spirit, because of the cesarean, she lost the child. She will be alive, but the child will be no more. That is the word of the enemy. Now hear the prophetic word. Thou sayest the Lord, I will preserve the life of the man that shall come the child. And the Lord said, nothing ever will happen to this child. The Lord said, this child will bring joy. I see in the spirit, the day this child will come forth, a star will hang in the atmosphere. People who have eyes can see the star. It will be like the days of Jesus. A great child is in the womb of your wife. Which one do you want, a boy or a girl? A boy, I know you want a boy. Should I tell you? You want to hear? The Lord said, I will give you the desire of your heart. Joy and happy in the name of Jesus. Nothing will happen to you. Therefore, the food you are eating. And who said, I say, I am quite missing, and you are here to call them my young one. Yasuma will be if you fear every side. Pray and be vigilant. You are blessed. Yeah. You asked me to leave this couple to do this. This is a seed of 500 seeds. And you said it's a seed of grace. Let this grace abound. Give the Lord.